everyone. My name's Webb, and I'm a virtual YouTuber. Many people don't know this, but I also have a background as an idol and a voice actress. Today, I'm going to teach you about how you should record your audio for singing. It's important to note that this is just a generic guide, and I will not be going into detail on how to mix your audio or clean it in any way. All right, step one. Pick out your DAW. You will not be recording on your phone and voice memos. You'll be recording only on your computer. And there's easy ways to record on your computer with software that makes the process smoother, like Adobe Audition or Studio One. These are DAWs you can pay for, but if you'd like some free software, my suggestion is Reaper. It may take a minute to learn any of these, but it will be worth it! Just click your red recording dot and sing your heart out, or maybe yell! Now step two. Your posture matters when you're making any sound. Stand when you're singing. You can use all the air in your body. Only using half of it when sitting down makes it harder to sing, and we can hear you strain. Use your diaphragm when singing, not your lungs. You want to feel your stomach fill up with air, not your breast. An easy way to tell is your shoulders will rise when breathing, and that's no good. When standing for singing, your posture should be feet parallel with your shoulders and standing up straight. Don't lock your knees, or you might faint. On to step three. Most people don't think about how important mouth placement is from the microphone. Make sure you are two fists away from the mic, and in between those fists, use a pop filter or a shield to protect you from shitty sounds like p-t-t-k. You can buy one of these on Amazon or make one yourself using old pantyhose and a wire coat hanger. Don't move too much from the spot you choose. It will affect the audio a lot. The microphone should be on a stand, but not close to any walls or propped up against anything. Do not hold it in your hands! It needs to be freaking still! The microphone should be above lip level and pointed slightly downwards. You don't want it to catch you panting or making weird noises. One more thing in the real world that may help you is a clean, clear space, and this doesn't mean clean your room. That's okay, keep living like that, King. It means that there should not be any reflective sounds in your audio. Having a soft space to absorb the sounds helps the audio mix better in the instrumental. You can cover your recording space with heated curtains, foam, or live under a giant comforter. Be careful, it gets hot under there. Step four, let's get recording. Record in mono with the settings of 24 to 32 bit and 44,100 hertz to 48,000 hertz. It should ask you for this when you create a new project in your program. You may see numbers beside your audio. This indicates how loud your audio is. Record around negative 18 decibel average. Don't go too much over negative 10 and never over negative 6. Record your audio with a reference of the original vocals. Timing vocals is one of the hardest things a mixer has to deal with. To make it easier on them, record on time and send the vocals pre-timed to the mixer. This doesn't mean cut them up like crazy. In fact, you should record takes as long as possible. That makes it sound more natural. Sing in tune. Sing on the same pitch as the original vocalist or guide that you're using for reference. If you find it hard to hear yourself, you can turn off the guide and listen back to your vocals. This brings up an important topic. Listen back to your vocals. You hear yourself differently than how you actually sound. So after every take, listen back to yourself. Make sure you like it. If you have any overlapping vocals, just move them to another track, but still be in time with the original. We can export this file as your name, mains, overlap. The naming conventions of your files are very important and should be clear for the mixer. Here are some examples. Your vocals are very special. After all, you just spent a whole lifetime recording them. Don't do any compressing, noise removal, nothing. Keep them as raw as the cow on your farm. Export them in a large enough file format, like WAV and not MP3. You can put them in a Google Drive folder and send them to the mixer of your choosing. Hopefully me, I'm gonna be your mixer. Yeah, you can commission me, I'm really cool. And you're done, maybe. If you have a different mixer, they may have different rules to follow. This is a very generic guide after all, and I hope you use this power for good. If you'd like me to mix for you, my prices are in the website in the description below. Tascaru!